Hello, I'm Mr. Armitage, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is continuation of Christianity, and any Sikh, you know, should be easily explaining the parables of the New Testament. Here I'm doing John 18, verse 1 to 18, Betrayal and Arrest of Jesus. When Jesus had spoken these words, he went out with his friends, not the blind, once-born disciples of the blind rabbis. This is a messianic, you know, Jew corruption. Across the Kidron Valley, where there was a garden, which he and his friends entered. Now Judas, who betrayed him, also knew the place, for Jesus often met there with his friends. So Judas, a psychic seeking his own glory and not glorifying our Father, having procured a band of soldiers, soldiers and some officers from the chief priests, that means the chief temple high priest, like Pope, you know, today, was very influential in politics. Now this Pope has his own army, you know, as police, you know. So you can see temple priests also used to have their own police to arrest somebody. And some officers from the chief priests. So chief priests give the officer, go and arrest Jesus. And the Pharisees were also, you know, very much against him. So they also went to arrest him, went there with lanterns and torches and weapons. Then Jesus, knowing all that would happen to him, because he had the very spirit of our Father, came forward and said to them, "Whom do you seek?" They answered him, "Jesus of Nazareth." Jesus said to them, "I am he." Judas, who betrayed him, was standing with them. You know, Nazareth means the one who has the eye, you know, not blind man. The light, man of light, is called Nazareth. Who betrayed him was standing with them. When Jesus said to them, "I am he," they drew back and fell to the ground in honor of Jesus. So they, you know, honored Jesus, you know, that Jesus, when they have seen the miracles and all that, so they honored him. So he asked them again, "Whom do you seek?" And they said, "Jesus of Nazareth." Jesus answered, "I told you that I am he. So if you seek me, let these men go." This was to fulfill the word that he had spoken, "Of those whom you give me, I have lost not one." Then Simon Peter, having a sword, drew it and struck the high priest's servant and cut off his right ear. That means Simon Peter was so devoted to Jesus, you know, that who the hell you are to come and catch up, prepare to die for him. The servant's name was Malchus. So Jesus said to Peter, "Put your sword into its sheath. Shall I not drink the cup that the Father has given me?" So Jesus, you know, he knew everything. So Peter, being faithful to Jesus, so he wanted to, you know, defend him. Jesus faces Annas and Caiaphas. So the band of soldiers and their captain and the officers of the Jews arrested Jesus and bound him. First they led him to Annas, for he was the father-in-law of Caiaphas, who was high priest that year. Now the chair of the high priest was sold or auctioned by the Romans. The Roman, you know, that king would auction it, so he will get the money. So to make that money, you know, they will then fleece people. So this business was going as it is today. Kaaba is the same situation. The chief mullah over there, the chair was auctioned by the Egyptians. And whoever the highest bidder will get it, then he will fleece people. It was Caiaphas who had advised the Jews that it would be expedient that one man should die for the people. Peter denies Jesus. Simon Peter followed Jesus. So he was, you know, he loving him. So he said, "Oh, I will." So did another laborer. So I think it was John, you know. Since that laborer was known to the, oh dear, known to the high priest, he entered with Jesus into the court of the high priest. But Peter stood outside at the gate, at the door. So who could be that? So the other friends of Jesus, who was known to the high priest, went out and spoke to the servant girl who kept watch at the door and brought Peter in. The servant girl at the door said to Peter, You also are not one of this man's friend, but she knows only disciples, you know. Disciples, are you? He said, "I'm not." Now the servants and officers had made a charcoal fire because it was cold, and they were standing and warming themselves. Peter also was with them, standing and warming himself. So that is the end, you know, of this one. Sorry, you know, it is so short.